TFNN.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. You are what you believe you are. Humans are powerful magicians. You have the power to make yourself what you are right now, but it's not your reasoning mind that controls your power. It's what you believe. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials one down 195, NASDAQ off 101, S&P's down 32. Gold. Gold contract down $5.30, trading at $18.82 an ounce. We have silver down 17 cents, $21.95 an ounce. Light sweet crude flat, $83.45 a barrel. Notes and bonds. The 10-year note down 20 ticks, trading 107.09. The 30-year off a full point, plus 24 ticks at 111.20 in King Dollar. Let's get ready for this one. King Dollar's up 733 ticks, trading at 106.552. The euro is out here at a price point of 105. The yen's at 149. The British pound is at 120.1 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at it. I'm going to go to the E-mini first because I want to show you something here on the E-mini. So, and we'll go through the S&P, you know, the SPY and all this. But the bottom line, right now, we made it to a low out here, which was down 52 points. Now we're down 32 rather. This thing's going to make a run. We're at 4377. It wants to run to 4387. That's going to be get us down 21 points. The real kicker is what's going to happen at that point. Because when you take a look at this chart, what you're going to see, and where I get that from, folks, is this. That's the last time that we had any volume on the way down, right there. So, and what we also had, we had volume. We had a sign of strength off this bottom. Look at this bottom. That's not the low. That's the spike off the low. So what you have here is that it's going to try to make it to that point. Now let's look at this. Because if we go from, not that one. We go from, what time was that? 8 o'clock. I'll take the whole thing. If we go from high to low today. Yeah, see, that's going to get interesting too. Because that's not a big deal. If we go from high to low, that is that number that I just gave you. That's between the 0.382 and 50 retracement of this leg that's down. That's one way of looking at it. Now let me do this, because that is from the, yeah, that makes sense. That's from the 8 o'clock bar. Well, let me do it the other way too. When I say the other way, what I want to do is actually the straight line move down and see what that move is. Because if we take the straight line move down, come on, where are you? Gotta find my, there it is. Okay. Yeah, see the straight line moved down too. That's a 50% move. That's a normal move. So now we go to the SPY and take a look at the SPY. What you're gonna see is that we've already rejected this area, and we rejected it yesterday. And now you get another rejection. We actually didn't hit the area. It's 431.04, or is it 02.01. It's 433.01. So we made it to 433.23. Now you're at 31. You're not going to have the volume. It's 90 million. Right now we've done 62. Well, we'll find out. Maybe it does 39, another 90 million. I don't think it's going to. I think what you're going to see here is it's going to try to charge into the close again, really blowing some minds, okay? We go to the 10-year note, which, you know, this smoked everything out here today, but you go to the 10-year note, and what you're going to see, we take a look at that 10-year note. You're down with 1.9 million contracts. Now, the difference, the S&P has given us a little rejection of lower price. The bond hasn't yet. What you can see, though, is that what you're, Let me get the volume up here for you. What you're going into is 2.5 million contracts, and you're only doing 1.9. So you're going to need a lot more contract volume to really bust this down again. Gold, it's intriguing, you know, that the dollar is up so dramatically, and gold really hasn't moved. Sideways move, you're down $5. Doesn't mean a thing. Do you know what I'm saying? You got up to the, you know, 1898, you're trading at 1881. Gold needs more volume. We're talking about the volume. It definitely needs more volume. If we do right there, that's what it's going to try to get into. We'll see how that shakes out. And then we go to the 30-year. We take a look at the 30-year out here. And what you're going to see with the 30-year, let's see. So we're down on 608,000 contracts. That's a lot of contract volume for a 30-year, I can tell you that, man. But what are we going into? Well, you're going into 777 and 711. So you are going into, you know, you haven't got a rejection of lower price yet, but you're still going to need more volume as you trade into lower price. And we'll see how this, well, then if we go to King Dollar, see, if we take a look at King Dollar does not look like it wants to back off. But what's happening is that the S&P, to me, looks like it wants to go up another 10 points. And if that happens, it's going to get kind of interesting in the whole context of it because we were down so hard, you know. And we'll see if that brings any movement. You know, most times that if you're testing, we're testing the underneath of the channel line, but this is more than just testing it because that wide price spread on the dollar, you know, when you're testing something, the bottom line is that if you have wide price spread, your higher probability is that you're going to, you know, basically stay up here. Now, that being said, you know, we'll see where we shake out here. You know, the dollar is only, it's still at its highs. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.